Potty Train in a Weekend, written by Becky Mansfield, narrated by Kirsten Oliphant. Meet Becky Mansfield. Hi, I'm Becky, founder of the blog Your Modern Family. YourModernFamily.com is dedicated to helping other parents raise their kids in the modern world without stress. I share fun ideas and teaching tools to incorporate learning into play, as well as tips about how to organize your home through it all. I'm also the founder of Blogging with Becky and Paula, which teaches others how to blog, make money blogging, and keep it on the side of more important things in life. Outside of work, I am blessed to be the mother to 4 children and the wife to my high school and college sweetheart. Before our eldest son was born, I was an elementary teacher. Now that we have children, I'm a part-time play therapist and stay-at-home mom. Working with young children has become second nature for me as I'm able to study children through play on a daily basis. I've taken many courses on child development over the years and have enjoyed the opportunity to really learn why our children do what they do. Our own children range in ages from 6 years down to 9 months old. With the exception of our baby, I've potty trained each one of our children in a weekend. After that, I shared my method with my brother and his wife, and they trained my niece and nephew in a weekend. Later, my friends used this same method with success. Once I began blogging, complete strangers began to ask me about my potty training methods, then reported back to tell me that they have had success as well. As I tell my friends, it's not the easy way to train, but it is fast and it is effective. Chapter 1. Why did I write this book? Most of my friends have children close in age to my own children. When I potty trained ours so quickly, they began asking for advice and input. The word must have spread because people that I didn't know started to email me to ask me questions about potty training. I decided to write a short post on my method, and the comments started coming in quickly. It then led to this information-packed book. I hope you find it helpful. How old were our kids when we trained them? Our first son was 20 months old when he was potty trained. He was pee trained very early on, but it was several months before he would have a bowel movement on the potty or would stay dry during the night. I will dig into these topics later in the book. Our second son was 22 months old when he was fully trained, pee and poop in one day. He stayed dry all day long. He was never able to fully control his bladder at night, so night training has not yet been successful with him, and I do not push it. Our third son was 22 months old when he was fully trained, pee and poop. He is dry almost every morning, but I still use a diaper on him at night just in case. He regressed after our fourth baby was born. He was 26 months old when his baby sister was born and had accidents for over a week. I'll talk about regression later on in the book. Pros and cons of early potty training. Pros: I didn't want the mess of diapers. I wanted to eliminate the constant diaper bill. I stay at home with our children, and a constant diaper expense can be a challenge to sustain. I talk about ways to save money in my other book, You Can Be a Stay-at-Home Mom on One Income. I didn't want to have to change a 3-year-old's dirty diaper. I wanted our children to feel independent, confident, and proud to wear their big kid underwear. It was just something that I wanted to do. It is not for everyone, but I personally wanted our kids trained early. I do not judge parents that wait for their children to be trained. I don't even notice, to be honest. Different strokes for different folks. Cons: our children were too young to dress themselves when I was training them, so I had to pull their pants off and on for them, which some might see as a bonus for waiting until your kids are a little older. I didn't mind this too much, but if you want to have an independent toilet trainer, you will have to wait. It takes a lot of work and a lot of effort. Still, if you put that effort in during this one weekend, you will see the benefits in just a few days. Why do I potty train them in a weekend? What a lot of moms do, and something that I think is confusing to our kids, is to put their child in diapers or a pull-up, but tell them to use the potty instead of going in their diaper or pull-up. Isn't that confusing? It would be like someone giving you a candy bar, but telling you to eat healthy. Or if someone gave you an electronic scooter, but told you to get a lot of exercise. Which is it, diapers or the toilet? This is why I do the naked method for 3 days. This is why it is successful. There are no gimmicks. It is not wishy-washy. Consistency is key. We go pee-pee and poop on the potty. We all do this, and now you will too. Yippee! The goal in our home, my own personal goal, was to have each of our children potty trained by the time that they turned 2 years old and to do it in a weekend, 3 days. This is just the main teaching time frame. You will still remind them for weeks to come. I liked our children to be trained by 2 years of age because it makes life so much easier, and it can be done. I am not one of those moms who feels like they will get it when they are ready. I wanted them trained and in underwear. It was easier for me in the long run, and I knew that they could do it. So they did. Children rise up to meet our expectations. It worked for us, and I hope that the same method works for you, whatever age you decide to give this a try. Chapter 2, Potty Training Around the World. How we train our children varies greatly based on our countries. It comes as no surprise that potty training in the United States is different from how potty training is handled in other countries. Let's take a look at the way that other countries potty train their children. India. In India, they start to focus on training their babies around the 6-month age range. Their method makes a lot of sense to me, although I would never have the time to even attempt this. They hold their babies above the latrine, and while they are doing this, they are making a hissing sound. The sound encourages them to go during these scheduled times. Most children in India are trained by 14 months old because they are praised for staying dry and reprimanded when they are soiled. Kenya. In Kenya, there is a tribal people group called the Digo tribe. They train their infants when they are just a few weeks old. I have heard of this, but have never attempted it myself. The reason is that there is almost always someone with the babies, so as soon as they notice the signs, they are taken outside and held over the ground. Are you ready for the best part? Most infants in this tribe, the Digo tribe, stay completely dry by 6 months of age until they are given the opportunity to go outside. How great for them! I'm sure that some of you are wishing you had done this, but it certainly isn't for me, and I'm not going to teach you how to do this and potty train in a weekend. China. The same thing is true in China. A baby is trained at just a few months of age, and they stay dry all day with frequent opportunities to go by 6 months of age. To train their babies, the babies are held over the potty or over the ground. Instead of hissing, as they did in India, the parents in China make a whistle sound, like the sound of urine. This signals the babies to go. When the children of China are a year old, they wear...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.